Can I use my TV as a second display? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is one of those questions that's obviously it's been around for a long time. It's one of my older questions, but the answer has been changing over the years, and honestly, it's becoming much, much easier. Chances are the answer is a very, very clear yes. Here's how, and here's why. One of the things that has happened over the years is that HDMI connections, which are the connections that you would normally use to connect your TV to a DVD player or a cable box or something like that, have become ubiquitous. They're on every brand new TV. All of the flat screen TVs now have them, and they're becoming significantly more popular on computers. Most notably, laptop computers, although many video cards that come with PCs now also include an HDMI out. The neat thing about HDMI, well, there's a couple of them. One is that you just plug the cable in at both ends and magic happens. Your PC learns what the capabilities of your TV or HDMI monitor are, and it just sort of shows up. Now, the other thing that is very cool about HDMI and honestly makes it preferable to almost every other alternative, it includes audio. All the other alternatives, and I'll go through a list of them here in a second, but all of the other alternatives are video only. HDMI, because it is designed specifically for television and movies and that kind of stuff, includes both video, high quality digital video, and audio. So a single connection to your TV will connect up both the video and the speakers that are on the TV. Now, what are those alternatives? Well, the alternatives, they vary. DisplayPort is a digital video and a data connection. It may in fact exceed HDMI in terms of the different things that it can do, but it is also not nearly as ubiquitous as HDMI. The nice thing though is that if your computer has a DisplayPort out or even a USB-C out, then there are connectors that will convert from DisplayPort or USB-C to HDMI and get you effectively the same kinds of benefits that we're talking about a pure HDMI to HDMI connection. DVI, Digital Visual Interface, is a video only but digital interface. It is probably the next most appropriate connection if both your computer and your TV has it. And indeed, some older TVs and monitors do still have a DVI connection. VGA is the old connection. It's the one that you remember from your PCs way back when. The problem with VGA is that it's analog. What that means is that the display that you are now originally used to seeing as pure digital is getting converted to analog, which means it will suffer from some quality degradation. In addition, VGA doesn't really handle the massive resolutions that we're used to today of HD 1920 by 1080 or higher very well. So it's kind of a last resort. S-video, so-called separate video, it's a higher resolution analog interface that can probably do a better job, again, at higher resolution. You're just not seeing it all that often anymore. And of course, component video, I just have to mention it because it's been around for a while. It's an analog interface, and it's the one that uses those three separate RCA-style connectors for red, green, and blue to connect up your video. If possible, use HDMI for everything you can when you're connecting up not just a TV as your second monitor, but even just connecting up a monitor to your PC. What I'm using right now is doing exactly that. I do want to talk a little bit about resolution because resolution is one of those things where we get a little bit of confusion, and it's also where a lot of these different interfaces have their limitations. So very quickly, it's all more or less now defined on television standards. Standard definition, or SD, is 640 by 480. 720 HD is 1280 by 720 pixels. 1080, that's what we now consider to be true HD more often than not, is 1920 by 1080 pixels, 1920 across by 1080 high. 4K or UHD, ultra high definition, is 3840 by 2160. You can see it's exactly twice the width and height of regular HD. Older analog televisions, if you remember those had an equivalent resolution to around 486 by 440. In other words, they were worse than what we now consider to be standard definition. And you can often see that if you're looking at older videos from old TV shows and so forth that are being displayed on TV, they just don't look nearly as crisp, and that's because they are at this lower resolution that has been upsampled to make it fit on your screen. When using a digital television with your computer, you want to make sure that you've got it set to the highest possible resolution that that television supports so that you can then get the highest quality output. Now, there is one thing about televisions that are different than computer monitors, and that is what's called overscan. Overscan is exactly what it sounds like. When a television show or television signal was displayed on a television screen, it was actually displayed to be a little bit wider than the actual physical screen. What that meant is that you would lose a little bit off the right and the left and off the top and the bottom. If you see that today with a digital picture being displayed on your television, what you'll notice is that like half the taskbar at the bottom is missing, or things are kind of sort of off the screen on either side. That's because your monitor is doing this thing called overscan. It's difficult to say exactly how you would fix this. Some monitors you can't. Some televisions you can. They will have adjustments that will allow you to bring the video in from the edges so that it actually does display every pixel that's been transmitted to it. But it is something to watch out for, especially when using a device that is intended to be a television as your computer display. Finally, great, you've got it hooked up. How do I make it work? In Windows, that's also something that's become significantly easier than in the past. In Windows, hit the Windows key plus the P key. That stands for projection mode. It's intended for situations where you're using a laptop with a projector or some other kind of display device for an audience. But in reality, it really just means this is how we want to use the second monitor, or the second device that's been connected to your PC. The options are actually fairly straightforward. You can use the laptop or the computer's embedded monitor only. You can use the external monitor only. You can mirror so that what's on one shows up identically on the other, in which case the resolution of one or the other will get set to the minimum that's commonly supported by the two. Or you can set up the screen to be an extension so that you could use both of them at the same time. They get extended into what's called a virtual desktop. So your laptop display might be the right hand of this thing, and then the external display might be the left hand part. You could drag things from one screen to the other simply by knowing where the two are virtually joined. But the bottom line here is that, yeah, absolutely, it's very common these days to very easily be able to use your television as a monitor or a second screen for your PC. Typically, all you need to do is hook up the HDMI cable and hit Windows P. For comments, for updates, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2597. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.